ask that everyone please rise for a moment of silence and the pledge of the flag. And I would like us to remember Charles C. Wyant, a two-term legislator from Highland Falls, and he was also the president of the board of directors of HOC. Roll call.
Coniston?
Here.
Turnbull?
Here.
Amo?
Here.
Anagostakis?
Here.
Benton?
Here.
Berkman?
Here.
Benelli?
Here.
Cantorino?
Here.
Cheney?
Here.
Dillard?
Here.
DeSalvo?
Present.
Ekus?
Here.
Fagion?
Here.
Hines?
Here.
Chemnitz?
Here.
Kulisek?
Here.
Paduk?
Here.
Ruskevich?
Here.
Sullivan?
Here.
Bureau?
Here.
Gresham?
Here.
21 present.
Okay, we have one speaker signed up. It's Jerry Kleiner from the city of Middletown regarding the Heritage Trail and the social host law.
Thank you. I had lots of notes, so I didn't have anything with me. All I was going to say.
You're pretty good.
I really wanted to thank the county executive, Russia. I mean, county executive Newhouse and Chairman Russia. Press release was a terrific show in support for the Heritage Trail, and she knows this is a project we've been pushing for from the last century in Middletown. This was probably 1994 it began. And, Orange Pathways and the Runners Club and so many different advocates. This would happen in other places. We see trails proposed and built, and we're still hoping. So I commend the call for unanimously passing this, and I would hope that it would pass unanimously. Boost to Middletown, I know the mayor and has strongly supported this, and Clayton Berkman, Duke, and we just had a lot of people advocating for a long time, the county planning department, H. Schmidt and John Spansky worked hard on this for a long time, and now Mr. Rose has really moved it forward. So we think it's not just long overdue, but we think it's really important for our overall development. I think it would just be a great thing, and we know how much it's used. So I hope that happens, and I thank everyone for that. And I just wanted to comment quickly on the social host law, because that's something, as a member of Middletown Cares, our group discussed that in actually beginning of June in 2014, when D.A. Hubler proposed the law. It was part of his Stop DWI campaign, and I can tell you when people were writing about other cultural happenings in the 60s. I was writing for our local newspapers in Texas about stronger DWI laws and how we really need to take that seriously. We've had a real culture change, I think, in that area. And I think this is part of that awareness and understanding, and Middletown Cares works for a alcohol and drug-free community for our youth to grow up in. This would support that. The law is originally written would make a first offense a misdemeanor. Corporation Council had objected to that. It also said anyone over the age of 18, and Town Care strongly felt that 18 in New York City's New York State 18 is you are no longer a minor at 18. It's majority, and within this law, minor means anyone under 21, but that's in terms of legally being able to purchase and consume alcohol. So I think if it does anything whatsoever to deter people and make them more accountable and more responsible and think twice before they have a party, host a party, do anything where they allow this kind of drinking, and this consumption getting out of hand. I think it will be a good thing, so I thank you. I thank you for the changes. I know the first offense now is just a violation. I think that's good. And really strongly support it. So.
Thank you, Jerry. Okay. Majority Leader Bonasek.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I move to approve the minutes of December 3rd and 17, 2015, and January 5th, 2016.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Carried. Are there any referrals, consents, or withdrawals? Majority Leader Bonasek.
Thank you again. I request that item number one on the agenda, local law introductory number one of 2016, a local law in relation to creating a continuum of care opportunities on real property near the Valley View Center for Nursing Care and Rehabilitation, and to increase health care opportunities available to residents of Valley View and others, all of that to be withdrawn from the agenda.
Second.
Discussion. Any objections? Okay, so granted.
Where are we?
Yes. Legislator Finelli, sorry.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I respectfully request consent to replace resolution agenda item number A1, which is the resolution confirming the appointments by the Orange County Executive to the Orange County Board of Ethics, with resolution which includes all seven appointments to the Orange County Board of Ethics.
Second.
Yes, Legislator DeSava. Are there any objections? So granted. Okay, we're ready for agenda item number one? That was withdrawn, I'm sorry. Okay. Okay, number two?
A1.
Okay, A1, sorry. All communications received and filed. Prime 1A. Mr. Chairman, can I move this?
Resolution confirming the appointments by the County Executive to the Orange County Board of Ethics pursuant to Local Law 5 of 2015.
Yes, Legislator DeSava.
I'd like to make an amendment to that and remove Joseph Joy at this time.
Is there a second to that?
Second.
Okay, roll call. On the amendment.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Nagnostakis? Benton? Berkman?
Yes.
Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney, Dillard, yes. DeSalvo, Ekus, Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Riskevich, Sullivan, Bureau, yes. Gresham, 21 ayes.
Okay, now we're on A1 again. So, as amended.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Nagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? Dillard? DeSalvo? Ekus? Fagione? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Riskevich? Sullivan? Bureau? Gresham? 21 ayes.
2A, received and filed. Local law, number two.
Legislators Bonasek, DeSalvo, and Amo. Local law introductory number 2 of 2016, a local law in relation to preventing the consumption of alcohol by minors on premises, Orange County social host law.
Second.
Discussion. Minority Leader Turnbull.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I'd like to put all Democrats on this floor as sponsors. Alcohol is a very powerful drug, and I think this is the right kind of law because I think it's going to generate a lot of educational activity, and I think the educational campaign is really the important thing that's going to happen. My hope is that in an effort to inform the public and let them know that allowing underage drinking is not going to be tolerated, hopefully is going to result in saving some lives. I don't think a year goes by where we don't have an incident of a person underage, and very often these are people who are leaving a party, jump in a car, and more often than not, they have other teenagers in the car with them. So I think this is really, really good law. I'm on the board of ADAC, and I think that hopefully ADAC will be the one that will be involved in the educational campaign because they're the ones that have been in the trenches with this issue for many years. So thank you.
Legislator, okay, you just want to ask that all Republicans be added? Yes. Michael, before you speak, you're next to speak. Do you want to add a sponsor to it? You're on it already, I'm sorry. Okay, go ahead. And then Legislator Ekus.
You know, I really am going to, I am definitely going to support it, and I hope this passes unanimously because it is the right thing to do. But when we do a law like this, I think the important thing is to understand that there are potential unintended consequences to families who don't fully understand it, and maybe even children who don't fully understand the consequences of this. And that's not our intention. Our intention is to try to reduce the occurrences of drinking of underage in homes. So I'm 100% behind what Mr. Turnbull said in terms of education. I really think, like any this law, all laws, we need to get the message out to everybody in Orange County that this is now a new law and that there's consequences. When we heard stories from Mr. Vero about how people could even lose houses if in fact they were sued as a result of some having a party at their house, or if they tried to use their insurance to pay for any damages, but now that we have a law and you're likely to not be able to use that insurance because you broke a law, there's a lot of questions here, and I think we owe it to the residents of Orange County to tell them what that is and make sure they understand it. And I know Mr. Hines has said they would do something like that in terms of education. I really hope we look at it seriously. I think ADAC is a great place to think about it. And I think we need to use social media. We need to use the PSA model to get this happening. We got to tell families. We can't have it after the fact that somebody realizes, you know, they've got huge consequences when they didn't realize they were doing something that was really bad.
I will say that this district attorney is coming back to public safety this month and Ways and Means with a $20,000 proposal for education, as you requested at the joint meeting.
Well, I think
with a plan.
Yeah, and I don't know if it needs to be the district attorney necessarily. I think Matt's point is ADAC is a really powerful group, and DSS is also someone actively involved in this issue. So I think we need to think about where we place the money and how we use it. That's my point.
Okay, well said. Yes, Legislator Ekus.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I certainly agree with everything that's said. I am glad that there is actually going to be an approach, whether it's the DA or anybody else, ADAC, for the educational aspect of it. I certainly am going to back this completely and totally. I do want to state publicly, though, that this law was brought to a head, as far as we're concerned, because of a terrible, terrible tragedy in this county. And I know that all of our hearts and sympathies go out to that family of everybody sitting up here. I also hope that we watch this law. As you know, I had difficulty with the term knowingly throughout the whole situation. Having spent a career working with teenagers, in high school and noting that a number of parties occurred this knowingly, I think we have to keep track of, and I hope the DA will come back and report whether this law is working the way it is. And of course, if not, we can always approach it again and make whatever adjustments we need. Thank you.
Okay, anybody else? Roll call.
Honestly?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnestakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? Dillard? DeSalvo? Ickes? Fagion?
Yes.
Hines?
Yes.
Chemnitz? Corsick? Paduk? Riskevich? Sullivan? Bureau?
Yes.
Gresham? 21 ayes.
And number three?
Legislators Amo and DeSalvo. Resolution authorizing the county executive in conjunction with the Orange County Department of Planning to accept and appropriate federal CMAQ funds and New York State matching grant for the second year in a multi-year commitment pursuant to Section 99-H of the General Municipal Law and Section 4.09 of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion? Yes. Okay, Jim Kulisek added.
Yeah, added?
Yes.
Okay, Curly's added too. Okay, roll call.
Coniston?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnestakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? Dillard? DeSalvo? Ickes? Fagion? Hines? Chemnitz? Corsick? Paduk? Riskevich? Sullivan? Bureau? Gresham? 21 ayes.
Okay, four through 10 are all bond resolutions requiring a two-thirds vote. Number four?
Legislators Benelli, Kulisek, Benton. Bond resolution dated February 4, 2016. Bond resolution of the County of Orange, New York authorizing partial reconstruction of various county roads stating the estimated maximum cost thereof is $1,300,000, appropriating said amount therefore and authorizing the issuance of $1,300,000 bonds to the county to pay the cost thereof.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Coniston?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnestakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? Dillard? DeSalvo? Ickes? Fagion? Hines? Chemnitz? Corsick? Paduk? Riskevich? Sullivan? Bureau? Gresham? 21 ayes.
Number five?
Legislators Turnbull, Bureau, Benton, and Hines. Bond resolution dated February 4, 2016. Bond resolution of the County of Orange, New York authorizing the removal of contaminated soil at various county-owned facilities stating the estimated maximum cost thereof is $100,000, appropriating said amount therefore and authorizing the issuance of $100,000 bonds to the county to pay the cost thereof.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Coniston?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnestakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? Dillard? DeSalvo? Ickes? Fagion? Hines? Chemnitz? Corsick? Paduk? Riskevich? Sullivan? Bureau? Gresham? 21 ayes.
Number six?
Legislators Riskevich, Turnbull, Benton, DeSalvo. Bond resolution dated February 4, 2016. Bond resolution of the County of Orange, New York authorizing the partial reconstruction of various buildings countywide stating the estimated maximum cost thereof is $100,000, appropriating said amount therefore and authorizing the issuance of $100,000 bonds to the county to pay the cost thereof.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Coniston?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnestakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? Dillard? DeSalvo? Ickes? Fagion? Hines? Chemnitz? Corsick? Paduk? Riskevich? Sullivan? Bureau? Gresham? 21 ayes.
And number seven?
Legislators Benelli, Turnbull, Benton, and Kulisek. Bond resolution dated February 4, 2016. Bond resolution of the County of Orange, New York authorizing the acquisition of building equipment countywide stating the estimated maximum cost thereof is $100,000, appropriating said amount therefore and authorizing the issuance of $100,000 bonds to the county to pay the cost thereof.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Coniston?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnestakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? Dillard? DeSalvo? Ickes? Fagion? Hines? Chemnitz? Corsick? Paduk? Riskevich? Sullivan? Bureau? Gresham? 21 ayes.
Number eight?
Legislators Benelli, Turnbull, Benton. Bond resolution dated February 4, 2016. Bond resolution of the County of Orange, New York authorizing acquisition of various equipment for county park facilities stating the estimated maximum cost thereof is $150,000, appropriating said amount therefore and authorizing the issuance of $150,000 bonds to the county to pay the cost thereof.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Coniston?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnestakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? Dillard? DeSalvo? Ickes? Fagion? Griskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Gresham, 21 ayes.
Number 9.
Legislators Griskevich, Turnbull, and Benton. Bond resolution dated February 4, 2016. Bond resolution of the County of Orange, New York, authorizing paving of various county park facilities, stating the estimated maximum cost thereof is $250,000, appropriating said amount, therefore, and authorizing the issuance of $250,000 bonds of the county to pay the cost thereof.
Second. Minority Leader Turnbull.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I'm going to ask for my name to be removed. I'm going to vote no on this, and these are the reasons. When I look at the capital plan, and it may be me, it may be just the way I'm looking at the plan, there are several paving projects in the plan, and I'm confused about why the parks are doing so many paving projects. And it seems like an awful amount of money, an awful lot of money. And that money is spread over several years, and since the cost of asphalt has dropped drastically, I don't understand why we're still paying the same amount for these paving projects that we were paying, you know, a couple of years ago when asphalt was at premiums. So I'd like this to go back at least and to get a better explanation. When it was brought to us, it was simply explained to us as paving and physical services, and then in Ways and Means, I believe that Mr. Rose did bring us additional information. It's not enough information for me to support this resolution today. Thank you.
I wish Commissioner Vidrock were here today, because I thought he wanted to get the bids out early and lock in on the lower price on asphalt. That was my understanding of physical. I don't know, Barry, is that true? And Katie, you remember the same thing. So I don't think we should delay it, but is there any other legislator that wants to speak? Okay, Barry first, and then Lee.
Thank you. The premise of this, of the use of this money, is to do as much paving as they possibly can. So the lower the price, the more paving that'll get done this year, which would mean that in subsequent years, the money in the capital plan could possibly be reduced. So I think that this is the time to move ahead with these types of projects when the price per unit is less expensive than it may, than it was in the past and maybe in the future. Lee?
Yes, thank you, Mr. Chairman. Yeah, it was stated at the committee meeting that in 2015 we did about 80,000 square feet. And this year, they're planning on doing at least 220,000 square feet. So they're doing considerably more paving, including the group picnic areas and at Sally's Dream and the parking lots at the park. So like everyone has said, it's time to, you know, do as much as we can while the price is low.
Great. Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
No.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis?
No.
Benton? Berkman?
No.
Benelli?
Yes.
Cantorino?
Yes.
Cheney?
Yes.
Dillard?
No.
DeSalvo? Ekus?
No.
Fagione?
Yes.
Hines? Hemnens?
No.
Kulisek?
Yes.
Padoue?
No.
Griskevich?
Yes.
Sullivan?
No.
Vero?
Yes.
Gresham?
Yes.
13 ayes, 8 noes,
fails. Mr. Bagwan, okay. Well, hopefully it goes back to committee this month. I sincerely hope so, because I don't want to lose out on that price. All right, number 10.
Legislators Padoue, Turnbull, Benton, and Berkman. Amending bond resolution dated February 4, 2016. Bond resolution of the County of Orange, New York. Amending the bond resolution adopted February 2, 2012 in relation to financing the cost of recreational area improvements at the county-owned Heritage Trail for the Department of Parks, Recreation and Conservation at the total estimated cost of
$8,913,000. Second. Discussion. Yes, Minority Leader Turnbull.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Please add all Democrats, and we're very, really pleased this project is moving forward. In fact, I was putting together a very nice press release for the Democrats. When I shared that with Mr. Ray Rose, who shared it with the county executive, who did his own press release. So I want to thank the county executive for doing a nice press release for me.
You, your name, or you want all Republicans? Is there any Republicans that don't want to be added?
Everybody okay?
Okay, Republicans, Democrats, Independents? And Jeff, you want to speak?
Nope, there's no paving.
Yeah, I know, we should log roll and say maybe, hold them hostage.
It was pretty funny, I raised my hand when you were asking if the Republicans were unanimously in favor, so I was raising my hand.
You're welcome, anytime.
That was a unique experience. I just want to share the moment with the people in Middletown. I mean, this is a long time coming, it was a promise made. I appreciate the unanimity of opinion here on the legislature. That's outstanding, I was going to ask it, and it was resolving before I made a request. I know that many people in Middletown, a lot of people deserve a lot of credit here for moving forward. I think that Mr. Rose does, and Mr. Szymanski does for planning. The county executive does for pushing forward with this. A lot of legislators backed it. And there was a home team support. Elizabeth Alberher, who's like the leader of the Middletown Heritage Trail Support Group. Jerry Kleiner, Alderman Kleiner, who spoke earlier, he deserves a lot of credit as well. Anyway, just it's a fun, happy moment that we could agree on something as important to my district and beyond. So thanks, everybody, for keeping a promise. Now let's just make sure that we keep to a timetable so we don't lose time in getting this job done. And Lee and I would, I'll take the liberty of doing that, invite everybody to come take a hike through the site as the weather breaks. It'll be a fun experience for us.
Yes, we should do that. Any other legislators? Legislator DeSava?
I'm going to support this today. I know I've been telling Mr. Berkman that I've been on the fence, but I wanted him to sweat it out a little bit. I just want to remind the legislature, and I know the county executive knows, as I spoke to him about it before, and also Chairman Cheney and Physical Services regarding the southern part of the trail in Harriman, and hopefully we'll work forward towards that in the near future and try to connect that with the train station. I think it'll bring a lot of more life to the trail overall as we move towards Middletown.
Good. Yes, Myrna.
So I would like to echo that sentiment because I did bring that up as well. I'd like to see it have a terminus in Harriman and have a definite place where it's going to end. I understand that because other projects for casino, et cetera, were being discussed down in that area, that Harriman was kind of put on the back burner for the trail. But it is extremely important that we know that Harriman will have an ending where it will be, and so that Harriman can then develop that area around it for its revenue that it definitely needs. So yes, I do really hope that this goes through on the southern part. Thank you.
And I think legislators Amo and Cheney also echo that sentiment. Paul?
Oh yeah, thank you, Mr. Chairman. I'm glad that this project is moving forward. I think it's a great project. However, I do want to point out in the previous resolution having to do with paving, I think some of that paving was going to parts of the existing Heritage Trail. So as we look to expand this trail, I hope that we keep in mind that we have to maintain what we have and continue to maintain it in the future.
That is correct. Okay, I'd like to, yes, Legislator Cantorino, sorry.
Let's see. I'd like to thank the legislature. I know correspondence has been sent in by the municipalities of Goshen because this would start in Goshen and end up in Middletown, and I think it's a wonderful thing. And they had the full support of the municipalities and appreciation. So I just wanted to weigh in on that.
I'd just like to, yes, Mike.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Just to what Jeff said, thanks to everybody that's been involved. I represent the first ward in the city of Middletown. And we've talked to a lot of economic growth. People here in Middletown have actually opened businesses knowing or hoping, like we've been hoping for such a long time, that the Heritage Trail would come through the city of Middletown. And there's some areas right now that are hoping that it's sooner than later. And economic development is a major part of this. And it's important for every community, really, and I can't wait to actually get it started.
Good, Senator Fagione.
Thanks for the mayor, too.
I'm happy that everyone's so happy and excited. Just as a reminder, geographically, the County of Orange does not end in Middletown. It ends in the town of Deer Park and the city of Port Jervis. So we would be more than happy in Western Orange County to look at ways of bringing the Heritage Trail all the way from Harriman, all the way to the city of Port Jervis. And I'd be glad to work with anybody on that.
Hopefully we can do that. I'd just like to thank the whole legislature for this cooperative effort. I know we've been very supportive, and Jim Kulisek suggested that we use the economic impact to go to the IDA. And I asked Harry Poore to go to the IDA with an application, which he did in short order with the county exec. And I even suggested the amount he applied for. And that made it easier for the legislature to buy into this too, because it was a heftier sum. And that $1 million is coming off of the county's share. So I would thank everybody that was involved with that as well as the IDA. It's been very cooperative. Thank you. Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Emo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cantorino?
Yes.
Cheney? Dillard? DeSalvo? Ickes? Fagione? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Ruskevich? Sullivan? Vero?
Yes.
Gresham? 21 ayes.
For 11.
Legislators Anagnostakis and Benton. Resolution authorizing the County of Orange to vacate a decision of the Supreme Court regarding an in rem foreclosure pursuant to Section 5, Paragraph B, 1 of Local Law Number 2 of 2010.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? Dillard? DeSalvo? Ickes? Fagione? Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Ruskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Gresham, 21 ayes.
Number 12.
Legislators Benton, Hines, and Kulisek. Resolution authorizing a private sale and conveyance of certain county-owned lands acquired by reason of a failure to redeem said lands from a tax sale to Orange County pursuant to Section 10184 of the Real Property Tax Law and Orange County Amended Local Law Number 2 of 2010.
Second.
Legislator Benton.
Yes, thank you, Mr. Chairman. In Ways and Means, can we split these? Can they be split today, please?
Yes. Okay, so we'll be voting on the Montgomery portion first, section first, is that correct? Yes, okay. Roll call on the Montgomery portion.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cantorino, Cheney, Dillard, DeSalvo, Ickes, Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Ruskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Gresham, 21 ayes.
Okay, discussion on the Malhope portion. Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cantorino, Cheney, Dillard, DeSalvo, Ickes, Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Ruskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Gresham. 20 ayes, 1 abstention.
Number 13.
Legislators Anagnostakis and Benton. Resolution authorizing the county executive to enter into an agreement with certain Orange County municipalities providing for the exemption from county taxation of lands owned and used by them for water supply and related purposes, pursuant to Section 4063 of Real Property Tax Law.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? Dillard? DeSalvo? Ickes? Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Ruskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Gresham, 21 ayes.
Number 14.
Legislator Benton, resolution approving the applications for the correction of certain errors appearing on the 2016 tax rolls for certain towns and districts and ordering the correction of said errors pursuant to Section 554 of the Real Property Tax Law.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? Dillard? DeSalvo? Ickes? Fagione? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Padoue, Ruskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Gresha, 21 ayes.
15.
Legislators Benton and Kulisek, resolution approving the applications for the correction of certain errors appearing on the 2016 tax rolls for certain towns and districts and ordering the correction of said errors pursuant to section 554 of the real property tax law.
Second. Discussion. Roll call.
Bonacek.
Yes.
Turnbull.
Yes.
Amo.
Yes.
Anagnostakis. Benton. Berkman.
No.
Benelli. Cantorino. Cheney. Dillard. DeSalvo. Ickes. Fagione. Hines. Chemnitz. Kulisek. Padoue.
No.
Ruskevich. Sullivan.
No.
Turnbull. I'm sorry. Vero. Gresham. 18 ayes, 3 noes.
16.
Legislators Benton and Hines, resolution approving the applications for the correction of certain errors appearing on the 2016 tax rolls for certain towns and districts and ordering the correction of said errors pursuant to section 554 of the real property tax law.
Second. Discussion. Roll call.
Bonacek.
Yes.
Turnbull.
Yes.
Amo.
Yes.
Anagnostakis. Benton. Berkman.
No.
Benelli. Cantorino. Cheney. Dillard. DeSalvo, Ickes, Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, Padoue,
no.
Ruskevich, Sullivan,
no.
Bureau, Gresham, 18 ayes, 3 noes.
And number 17.
Legislators Ickes and Ruskevich. Resolution authorizing the county executive in conjunction with the Orange County Department of Health to accept and appropriate supplemental grant funds from the New York State Department of Health pursuant to section 99-H of the general municipal law and section 4.09 of the Orange County Charter.
Second. Discussion. All Dems want to be on that?
Yes.
Good. Phil, you want to be on it too? Anybody else? Okay. Roll call.
Bonacek.
Yes.
Turnbull. Amo.
Yes.
Anagnostakis. Benton. Berkman. Benelli. Cantorino. Cheney. Dillard. DeSalvo. Ickes. Fagione. Hines. Chemnitz. Kulisek. Padoue. Ruskevich. Sullivan. Vero. Gresham. 21 ayes.
Or 18.
Legislators Ickes and Ruskevich. Resolution authorizing the county executive in conjunction with the Orange County Department of Health to accept and appropriate funds from a National Association of County and City Health Officials pursuant to section 99-H of a general municipal law and section 4.09 of the Orange County Charter.
Second. Question? Yes. All Dems on that one? Okay. Roll call.
Bonacek.
Yes.
Turnbull.
Yes.
Amo.
Yes.
Anagnostakis. Benton. Berkman. Benelli. Cantorino. Cheney, Dillard, DeSalvo, Ickes, Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, Padoue, Ruskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Gresham, 21 ayes.
Okay, number 19.
Legislators Bonacek and DeSalvo, resolution authorizing the county executive in conjunction with the Orange County Sheriff's Office to accept funds from the New York State Department of Homeland Security and Emergency Services pursuant to section 99-H of the general municipal law and section 4.09 of the Orange County Charter.
Second. Question. Dems on that one too. Jim, you're a Dems last time I looked. Okay. I'm losing you. Okay. Roll call.
Bonacek.
Yes.
Turnbull.
Yes.
Amo.
Yes.
Anagnostakis. Benton. Berkman. Benelli. Cantorino. Cheney. Dillard. DeSalvo. Ickes. Fagione. Hines. Chemnitz. Kulisek. Padoue, Ruskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Gresham, 21 ayes.
Okay, number 20.
Legislators Bonacek and DeSalvo, resolution authorizing the county executive in conjunction with the Orange County Department of Emergency Services, Fire Services, to accept grant funds from the New York State Division of Homeland Security and Emergency Services pursuant to section 99-H of the general municipal law and section 4.09 of the Orange County Charter.
Second. Okay, all Democrats on this one too. Discussion. Roll call.
Bonacek.
Yes.
Turnbull.
Yes.
Amo.
Yes.
Anagnostakis. Benton. Berkman. Benelli. Cantorino. Cheney. Dillard. DeSalvo. Ickes. Fagione. Hines. Chemnitz. Kulisek. Padoue. Ruskevich. Sullivan. Vero. Gresham. 21 ayes.
Okay, number 21.
Legislators Berkman, Ickes, and Dillard. Resolution recognizing February as Black History Awareness Month.
Second. Question.
All Dems, all Republicans, and Michael? Okay. Roll call.
Bonnison?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnestakis? Benton? Berkman? Vanelli? Cantorino? Cheney? Dillard? DeSalvo? Ickes? Fagion? Heinz? Chemnitz? Kolsek? Paducah? Skevich? Sullivan? Vero? Bresch? 21 ayes.
Okay, number 22.
Legislators Benton, Cheney, Bonnison, and DeSalvo, an act amending the appropriate Orange County employment schedules to reclassify principal account clerk to associate account clerk two at the Orange County Department
of Health pursuant to section 2.02i of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
This is law, though. Did you say health? I thought you said health. Yeah.
Department of Law.
Langdon was getting a little nervous back there, I think.
I apologize.
Discussion. Roll call.
Bonnison?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yep.
Anagnestakis? Benton? Berkman? Vanelli? Cantorino? Cheney? Dillard? DeSalvo? Ickes? Fagion? Heinz? Chemnitz? Kolsek? Paducah? Skevich? Sullivan? Vero? Bresch? 21 ayes.
Legislators Cantorino, Cheney, Paducah, and Turnbull, an act amending the appropriate Orange County employment schedules to abolish two laborer, one seasonal, and create two laborer, two at the Orange County Department of Public Works, Division of Environmental Facilities and Services, pursuant to section 2.02i of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion. Yes, Legislator Paducah.
It's just reading because in committee we want to go from seasonal to full time and it doesn't say that, so I just take it for granted that laborers mean full time now.
Yeah.
Right? You didn't put it in? Okay. Thank you.
Okay. Roll call.
Bonnison?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnestakis? Benton? Berkman? Vanelli? Cantorino? Cheney? Dillard? DeSalvo? Ickes? Fagion? Heinz? Chemnitz? Kolsek? Paducah? Ruskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Bresch, 21 ayes.
Okay, number 24.
Legislators Cheney, Fagion, Benelli, and Kolsek. An act amending the appropriate Orange County employment schedules to create recycling coordinator at the Orange County Department of Public Works, Division of Environmental Facilities and Services, pursuant to section 2.02i of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion. Okay, all Democrats will be added. Jeff?
Yes.
Chris?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, again. I did want my name added, so I appreciate that. But I'm also very excited that we're actually hiring this recycling coordinator, which is part of our master plan. And we need to get to this before we start getting fined for not having this particular position. And I'm hoping that this, whoever it is that fills this position, is truly concerned with recycling and will actually end up making money for the county through the hiring of this position. Because I think that is one of the biggest resources that we have out there is our waistline, and much more can be recycled. So thank you very much for considering this.
All Republicans want to be added to this too? Okay, Michael? Okay, Rob, yes, Katie?
Sorry. I really just wanted to publicly thank Pete Hammond, who was very instrumental, along with Chairman Cheney, in facilitating this. This had been brought to my attention when I was chair of Physical Services, and worked with Mr. Cheney, along with some members of the community. And this was one of the steps that we felt that we could continue, that we could pursue, as far as looking at sustainable options for the way we address our lifestyle here in Orange County. And they were very helpful as well. So I want to publicly thank Legislator Cheney along with Pete Hammond from Environmental Facilities. They did a great job moving this forward, and hopefully we will see our money one day, as far as this is a particular position that we have applied for a grant, and we will get 50% of it someday. Thank you.
Legislator Cheney?
Just to echo everything that's been said up until now, but this initiated the relook at it, because this position had existed over 10 years ago and was filled and a valuable position, but the position became vacant and then it was lost. But the discussions when this began
Physical Services was being chaired at the time by Legislator Benelli, and she had the good foresight to say that this was something that we needed to pursue. Thank the legislative body for including monies in the budget for this year to support this, and look forward to getting money from the state and moving forward with a really strong education program to the residents of the county, so we can increase the amount of recycling and that thus reduce the cost of disposal of solid waste that has to be trucked out of the county. Thank you.
Senator Berkman.
I remember when Bill Gunther was the recycling coordinator, and what a good job he did, and just wanted to mention his name. And I think it was a mistake, actually, to eliminate the position. And I think this is an excellent corrective measure. The fact that it's state funded by half is an extra bonus. We know we can do a better job. We know it's the right thing to do to get valuable products out of the garbage stream. And coincidentally, I was trying to recycle a television set today. And not an easy proposition. There was a store that used to do it for free. Now it's at $25. You know, you have to keep a good eye on making sure that we serve the public, to make it convenient for the people of Orange County to dispose of items rather than making it expensive, because if that happens, we're going to start seeing garbage on the roads, which would be horrible.
Legislator Egas.
Thank you again. Just to help out Mr. Berkman, our transfer stations take your first television for free, and then $15 for everyone after that. So we do have that opportunity. And I thought also it might be, because I didn't mention it before, it might be a good time to remind our chairman about that green committee out there.
We didn't forget about it.
Thanks.
EA to be announced. Okay, roll call. Sorry, Mike, you want to talk?
Just wanted to go one up. The town of Walk Hill takes as many TVs, VCRs, up at our DPW station and actually takes care of them for you for free.
Great information, you guys.
Okay, roll call.
Bring them all to Mike's
house. Honasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Abel?
Yes.
Anagnostakis, Benton, Berkman, Benelli, Cantorino, Cheney, Dillard, DeSalvo, Ekis, Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Ruskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Gresham, 21 ayes.
Number 25.
Legislators Fagione, Sullivan, Turnbull, and Kulisek. An act amending the appropriate Orange County employment schedules to create park maintenance mechanic at the Orange County Department of Parks, Recreation, and Conservation, pursuant to Section 2.02I of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? Dillard? DeSalvo? Ekis? Fagione? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Ruskevich? Sullivan? Vero? Brescia? 21 ayes.
And number 26.
Legislators Fagione, Sullivan, Benelli, and Ruskevich. An act amending the appropriate Orange County employment schedules to reclassify heavy motor equipment operator to engineering equipment operator 1 at the Orange County Department of Parks, Recreation, and Conservation, pursuant to Section 2.02I of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney, Dillard, DeSalvo, Ekis, Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Ruskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Brescia.
Okay, number 27.
Legislator Brescia. Resolution appointing members of Labor Relations Advisory Committee pursuant to Article 4, Section G of the Legislative Manual.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton, Berkman, Benelli, Cantorino, Cheney, Dillard, DeSalvo, Ekis, Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Ruskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Russia. 21 ayes.
Okay, number 28.
Chairman Brescia, resolution appointing members of the Orange County Economic Development and Gaming Committee pursuant to Article 4, Section G of the Legislative Manual.
Second.
Discussion? Yes, Legislator Emmy.
I want to thank you, Mr. Chairman, for appointing this committee. And as I look at it now, I'd like to set the odds at 8-5 that it'll pass unanimously.
Jim, this Kulisek, this is the committee that you expressed interest in?
Yes.
So if anybody wants to get off during the year or whatever, let Jim know. We would like to get on at some point.
Also, one item on the bottom, it says the 5th day of February. I don't know if that needs to be corrected or not.
Mine says the 4th day.
No, it's sealed tomorrow on the 5th.
Oh, okay. Right. Okay, roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Hamel?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? Dillard? DeSalvo? Ickes? Fagione? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Ruskevich? Sullivan? Vero? Russia. 21 ayes, Mr. Chairman, and the desk is clear.
And we have no speakers signed up for afterwards, right? Okay. I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved. Second.
We're adjourned.